Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we went deep into the inner workings of the matte container. So hopefully you are now able to key your imported files with alpha as layers in the sequence. Now we'll turn our attention to text in the timeline and some alpha options that will affect the way you work. So let's start off with an easy example. You would like to add a title on top of some video in the sequence. The simplest way to achieve this is to add an empty video track above your edit. Now you can splice the section where you want the text to appear and select it. Right-click on this gap segment and add effect. Choose text. I'll enter into the text editor, add a new text layer, and type some text. I am going to stick with a simple white title, but you can change the formatting to whatever you want. So you now have a title, and I'll exit the text editor back to the sequence. You apply the text in this manner because it allows you to separate the title from the background. This means you can alter the timings of your title at any point simply by trimming it. You can also fade the title up and down by adding dissolves to the segment. Finally, you can also create title presets by dragging the segment to a folder in the media library. So that's a quickie lesson on how to create a title onto a sequence. But the main point of this video is that the text timeline effects internally generates the alpha. So let's go ahead and composite the text even further. So for example, I want to reposition the title in 3D space. Bear in mind, this is 2D text and not 3D text. So without going into advanced node compositing, you can do this all using the axis timeline effects. I'll select my text segment and apply the axis timeline effects using the effects ribbon. We can now go into the axis editor and start to reposition the title. But look at what is happening. It looks as though the text has been glued in the background and the background is moving in 3D space with the text. This is because the internally generated alpha in the text tool has not been passed up through the effects pipeline to the axis timeline effects. This catches a lot of people out when they start doing things like this. To remedy the issue, come out of the axis editor and go into the text editor. Here you will find the RGBA toggle. Changing this option will push the alpha up through the effects pipeline. So if we exit the text editor and go back into the axis editor, you will see that the text is once more separated from the background and you can position it in 3D space. Incidentally, this RGBA toggle in the text tool will affect all timeline effects upstream in the effects pipeline. This includes wipes, color corrections, and Spark plugins. What I have shown you is the most common example of what can happen with the generated alpha of 2D text and how to deal with it. In the next video, we move into node compositing with ConnectFX and see how the alpha functions in that environment. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.